You act as though you were never like me before. Like you were never young and foolish and far from a model student. Did you forget that you once walked in my shoes? When you would fall into stupidity, toes and feet first. Play with life although many times told to rehearse. Jumped into relationships and chose to forego the research. Like you ain't been there, done that and bought the t-shirt. Like you never had a dream that you would strive for. One that you were willing to dedicate your life for. You act as though you were perfect. When you parlay your knowledge around as though you were equipped with it. I'll say it straight. Most parents are hypocrites. Cause you can forget that you were once exactly like me. Except when it's time to remind me that you know better. And close your argument with experience is the best teacher. But you see, that doesn't always work. Because just because you spent years in a classroom, that doesn't mean that you always learn. And just because you experienced something, that doesn't mean that we have to infer that you were the best student either. And I'll openly admit that in most instances, parents are right. But it's not about our decisions being right or wrong. It's more about using your experience to sympathize and let us know that you at least understand where we're coming from. Because at least then we can take that in all seriousness and then decide. But instead it's I'm big, you're small, I'm right, you're wrong, and there's nothing you can do about it. You make our decisions sound irrational and practical, when I'm sure there was a time when you had the exact same thought. When you probably didn't know what you wanted to do with your life by the time you were 18 and had not already achieved it by 25. And when it came to everything else, it was all about patience and timing, right? But when it came to me and my life, those lessons no longer applied because I had to be great tomorrow or my plans had to work out today. If I'm not a millionaire right now, then all my efforts have been in vain. We look up to you as our teachers and our leaders. But how are we supposed to achieve success if the person that's supposed to be our biggest fan is never in the bleachers? It's like chasing a dream with a coach that has no faith in the team. To parents whose son spends all day playing football games on that Xbox and that PSS3 that you spent too much money on just to shut him up for his birthday. Well, did you know that there are thousands of people on YouTube making money from doing exactly the same? And millions of more opportunities in industries related to game. Have you ever tried to cultivate that interest? Have you ever even touched the controller, except when he left it on the floor and you broke it by accidentally stepping on it, withering in pain, watching him complain as you told him that you're not going to buy him a new one because it shouldn't have been on the floor in the first place. And every time he slipped in a grade or stayed out too late, you locked it away. I know a girl who, according to her parents, spent too much time at singing recitals, so they tell her to shut up so they can watch American Idol. I know a child who is trying to start a business which his parents have never shown an interest in or have a penny invested, but still encourage him to sit down with them and watch The Apprentice. What about the ones that are constantly emphasizing the importance of having a backup plan? The kicker is the backup plan concept. I don't even need to explain that because everybody knows what I'm referring to. But let me put it like this. How comfortable would you feel standing on the front line with a general who keeps emphasizing your role and its importance but spends his whole time investing his efforts in the reinforcements? Just think for a second, because if you show more interest in a person's backup plan than the actual plan, then you're actually, accurately, fractionally, factually, and practically, tactfully, didactically, drastically showing where your faith in his plan actually stands. Put yourself in our sneakers for a bit, and because statistics show, I think, that between 16 and 18 your feet no longer grow. So it's not that they don't fit, it's just that since you started walking on water, you've forgotten it. And stop trying to overshadow, but understand us kids. Because eventually when they become adults, any success they have, rather than just contributing, I bet you'd rather they say that you were actually a part of it. Because apparently I'm a patron of confusion and never offer any solutions to fairly obvious conclusions, simply because I feel it's not my place to say that my opinion works for everyone. But just in this instance, here is a simple one. Talk to your little one, because no matter how much you like to believe it, it's 2013 and no one is really a kid anymore. With access to clips at our fingertips, we're exposed to the world without having to open the front door. So ask them what their dream is, how and what we can do to achieve it. Your children are your biggest asset, so invest time in speaking, invest time in listening, invest time in hearing, invest time in learning how to play Pro Evolution Soccer and fashion trends and sing Beyonce. Just invest time in not just being a responsible adult. And I agree, you spoil the child if you spare the rod. But ultimately, we just want you to believe in us. Because a family is the strongest corporation that you can have.